Hello, LEGO fans, and welcome back to another Then and Now review, where I look at a LEGO set from then and see how it compares to a LEGO set from now, and which one is overall the better set. See if nostalgia outweighs the fancy building bricks and whatnot, and stickers. But yeah, so if you haven't guessed, today's video is Star Wars themed. I don't have that many Star Wars figures. I don't really collect that much Star Wars things. Basically just figures that I know and or cool little spaceships. I only collect spaceships that big, really. Anything bigger than that is a little too much to dust over time. We have Darth Vader here, who may be off camera. We have Akbar, Han Solo, Yoda, the Jawa, the Helmet Dudes, and R2-D2 and D2 and C-3PO here. The two compadres, my two favorite guys, and a little Masteroid over here in the corner. These are basically all my figures. And you may see them again later on. I may do a little review based on something that they may have came with. Who knows? I'm still debating that. But yeah, so today's review is very special to me because actually it is a set that I have owned in the past. Wow, an old LEGO set that I have once owned? Wow. I know, novel concept, but generally when I do these videos, they're old LEGO sets that I've gotten through thrift stores and have basically just bought the modern equivalent and see how it fares up. Usually I go for the modern equivalent. But I think today I may go for the nostalgic old version instead. This set was basically redone over the years to an ad nauseum amount. It is Luke's Landspeeder. Basically started 1999 and is still going today. The set that I have is actually the very latest one. And in fact, the very first one that they ever made, too. So we'll be looking at kind of a retrospective on either end of the timeline for this, I don't know, vehicle. So yeah, the very first Landspeeder here comes from 1999. It is set 7110, Landspeeder. It is not Luke's Landspeeder, it is just Landspeeder. Very simple. The names back then were rather simple. For Star Wars sets, they were rather non-specific. They're still diving into things, still figuring things out. This set was not originally mine. I got this one through BrickLink. I originally got this because I wanted to finally figure out where this random piece it came from in my LEGO collection. Over the years, this one random piece would stick out in my collection as I were to dig through. And so finally, I decided, you know what, I'm going to figure out what set it was. And when I saw a photo, I knew I had to have it because I instantly knew and remembered that I had built this at one point in time. I bought it. Thankfully, somebody on BrickLink had one of these for sale and the two minifigures that I'll share with you later. And it was just a nostalgia trip the whole time. I remember every little curve, and I think at one point I'd use the hood here to make a beach. kids. I still probably have some of these parts somewhere. Who knows? But I definitely only have one engine left. I'm not really sure how that worked out. But this whole set is basically how I remembered it, except for the fact that these seats use two jumper plates to hold each one in kind of at a off-angle way. They use modified kind of angled plates here on the edge, too, so that the minifigure's arms can hold in there, too. Oh, no, that's kind of... Okay, well, you just stay there. And the fact that this engine is held on with a Technic piece and a inverted propeller brick plate thing. It's really kind of a cool way they have the connection on. I would have expected a modified snot plate here. That's just generally how they've been doing it as of late, but I guess this is just an old school way they did it. I basically remember playing with this toy by picking up by the back engine, which is probably why I still only have one. I probably just flinted it off at one point, and who knows what happened to it. But anyway, I remember just playing with it several inches above the ground and going whoosh a lot. It was really quite a lot of fun, and obviously has really stuck with me. So if anything has swayed my vote in this review, it is definitely the nostalgia factor and the whoosh factor, I guess. So while this is still on camera, let me take a look at the other set that I have. This is from the year 2020. In the year 2020. Oh, boy. What a year. I digress. This is set 75271, Luke Skywalker's Landspeeder. Wow, this actually belongs to him. Huh. Wow, they really got specific then. As we can see, this one actually just dwarfs the other set considerably. There we go. Good side-by-side comparison there. Here, do it that way. So yeah, it's easily a couple percentile larger, and is a little bit heavier, a little heavier to hold, a little more awkward, but I digress. I'm getting a little ahead of myself. This is really kind of a cool and detailed set. It is, if you want a really detailed model to kind of go off of, just the way that they do the stickers and the broken down engine here, the good one over here with the still good markings, just the way that they do all this is so superb. I know most of it is with stickers, but just the way that they all tie it all together, just it makes you feel like you're in the movie. You can kind of see it. This is basically what I imagined when I used to play with this set. So it's kind of weird to actually be holding a set similar to what you imagine. I wouldn't imagine all the stickers, but I'm not against stickers in any way. They really add to this set. I'm not really sure if they'd be able to do really this whole thing here, this whole curve with the kind of modified bricks here. So hats off to them for going for a sticker. yeah, this is a really kind of a nifty little set. The selling feature for this set is actually that you can bend this back engine backwards and remove a hidden compartment where Luke has his desert jumper and binoculars, I guess. Kind of unnecessary, in my opinion. And it also makes this a little bit unwieldy if you're to play with it. If you were to pick it up by the back, woo, see, it were to fall right off. Thankfully, there's a little inverted thing there to hold it all into place. And thankfully, everything's stayed in there. I guess that's the trunk. But the way that they compensated for this is they have a little skid plate for you to scooch it around on the floor and cause a hit and run. Here we go, Diane. Get out of there. Yeah, it's it has some shortcomings, but it makes up for those shortcomings. I mean, honestly, when you design something in Lego, you have to make some compromises. And I think overall, they came across pretty well. They did their job. They made some design choices. Like, I would not have thought to have foldable seats there. But and the other side, steering wheel. In fact, the other one doesn't even have a steering wheel. So I guess I just imagined it with a little control panel all these years. Also, it comes with a little gun, which is just a long gun with a lightsaber stuck to the end. Oh, boy. oh, and also comes with this little Jawa guy, but he's not part of this. So, yeah, he can stay right over there. So, while we're talking about minifigures, let me get both of these out. And let's talk about the minifigures. Back in the day, they used to use yellow to represent actors in Lego. And now, they've switched to the skin color palette. So, you'll see representations of the actor's skin color in Lego, which is really kind of nifty. Really gets the point across of who that actor is sometimes, because after a while, once you see one yellow figure, they all kind of blend together. But that said, I do prefer the yellow figures. In fact, most of my Lego figures in my city if not all, except for Batman, I believe, will be yellow-faced. In fact, all of the figures that have since been released with skin tones have been replaced with yellow skin tones, just so that it's a consistent thing throughout my city. But anyway, I digress there. Here on the far left, we have Obi-Wan Kenobi in his robes, I suppose, with legs. Moving on over, we have Luke Skywalker here looking all smug with his generic haircut, the same kind of haircut as Obi-Wan. I also enjoy the stubble there on Obi-Wan. Luke's looking a little smug with his downward eyes and his little smirk. He just has a simple printing on the front here. There's his belt with the little knee pads. Slight misprinting there, but hey, I don't really care. I really love this figure just because I remember all the hours I used to play with him and hold him by the head, and I just really wonder what happened to that old minifigure. That would be really funny if old minifigures could talk, you know? So moving on over, we can see that Luke has gotten shaggier in this remake. If we want to look at it in the story sense, this land speeder is after Luke and Obi-Wan meet up and go to the desert crawler run by the Jawas, I believe. And this one is actually taking place around, I believe, the Tusken Raiders. I can't really remember. But yeah, it's very interesting. They both take place in different points in time. This one comes with C-3PO, but he can just be over there or just right here for now. Stay. But yeah, we can see they got a little shaggier. His little mouth dimple has gone into a tan color. And overall, his garments make a little bit more sense. I don't really know where the end of his shirt and pants begin, but that really didn't matter back in the day. In fact, it's kind of funny to see lead printing back then. So I think this might have been a rarity in that case. But digressing aside, which set is the best one? In play value, I would have to go for the nostalgic old Lego set. For the new modern collector who likes all those fancy details and everything else, I would go for this one. But personally, I would go for this. So there we go. Old wins, because I have a deep, deep nostalgia factor for this, and you can just go right over here. If you like to see reviews like this, retrospective reviews and reviews of old sets and just whatever Lego I might be able to come across, like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.